150 years ago, Joseph Gales was a policeman in our nation's capital. He was later assigned to the White House and grew as personal friends with President Abraham Lincoln. On Good Friday, 1865, he escorted President Lincoln to Ford's Theater and was one of the first officers to respond when he was shot. On that unforgettable night, he carried the 16th president across the cobblestone streets to where America's most beloved president would die the next morning. Joseph Gales is not the entire story. Joseph is his first name, Gales is his middle name, but Shelton is his last name. Ironically, what are the odds? One of my ancestors planted in life the cherry blossoms, and my other ancestor carried the president in death. The Bible says, despise not the day of small beginnings. You may not believe in God, but God believes in you. Divinity deposited his DNA in you, and you were made in his image. The Lord makes no junk. 2,000 years ago, Mother Mary was pregnant with the Son of God. She carried greatness and was the first to carry the gospel and God in the process. David, with a slingshot and a couple stones, carried greatness, not in his hands, but his head and heart. The Bible says a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. David toppled Goliath in private way before he destroyed him in public. Greatness comes with a price. Joseph, with a coat of many colors, had haters. They were not jealous of his colorful coat, but the colossal call of God on his life. In life, you can carry greatness or bury it. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. carried greatness with the clarion call to let freedom ring as he helped pave the way with the March on Washington, speaking on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial, delivering one of the greatest speeches of all time. His dream ended the nightmare for millions of African Americans, and with the Lord's help, they overcame. But like Lincoln, died in riot to others' promised land. What went through the head of Joseph Arimathea the day on Good Friday at Calvary when he begged for the body of his Lord? What courage to confront Pontius Pilate, whom just sentenced that his Savior be slain? Today, will the real men and women of God stand up? We've been sitting out for far too long. As Christ climbed the cross, he embodied grace and greatness and took on our sin. He truly set the people free. God used a borrowed womb with Mary and a borrowed tomb of Joseph to be the bookends of Christianity. Today, the God of the universe is looking to not only borrow you, but indwell in you for eternity. Christ died and rose again that you could live. Yes, my ancestor carried the closest to the king of a nation America will ever know. What an honor. But we don't just carry the president or a preacher in their death, but the living Prince of Peace in our lives. It is one thing to carry an earthly king, but we carry heaven's only king by our life and our lips. We all carry greatness, but it is entirely and eternally different when greatness carries you.